Okay, I'm a mom, Cancer. My final project was on social media activism. As you can see, the new form of activism, digital media activism. Here are my table of contents. First off, I'm gonna take you through the introduction. Then I'm gonna go through Black Lives Matter, Trayvon Martin, Freddie Gray, Philando Castile. Then we're gonna take a turn and touch on Standing Rock. Then we got Donald Trump, Colin Kaepernick, and two articles that pertain to Colin Kaepernick, the conclusion, and then we'll look at my sources. So here's just social media activism for the people, by the people. And I came across a little picture online that just shows like people speaking out on all the different social media platforms that we have. And first, my introduction. We live in a time where social media is a very immense part of all of our lives. In fact, in recent years, social media outlets have taken the place of news channels and newspapers as our main source to find out what's going on in the world. So with that being said, there's no surprise that citizens from all over the world have felt that when something bad takes place, the first place to go and vent and talk about it is social media. Anything worth fighting for is not accomplished easily, but with the help of social media, the things that people fight for has a better chance of being accomplished. And although that is great and innovative, it has still not yet helped bring about the change that people are seeking out to get. So first, I'm going to start off with Black Lives Matter. In 2012, Trayvon Martin was murdered in cold blood, which sparked an outrage in the country. Upon the jury's disappointing verdict, immediate protests began taking place nationwide in support of Trayvon Martin and his family, mainly on social media. In 2014, Eric Garner was choked to death by the police, and unarmed Michael Brown, spotted here, he was shot down by a police officer, and in both situations, it sparked an outrage, of course, because they were both recorded, they were both put out in the media, they were both shared across all social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, you name it. And eventually it led to the Black Lives Matter movement with the hashtag BLM, standing for Black Lives Matter. Then after the Eric Garner incident, we had the Freddie Gray incident, spotted here. It marked a moment where people stopped peacefully protesting, because in the other three situations, people just took to the streets to protest and, you know, marches, things like that. And once Freddie Gray took place, people just got tired of that. And they were like, you know, since we're not being heard, let's take a different approach. And then they took to actually rioting and looting in Baltimore. So that was another thing. And then next was Philando Castile. Last year, he was murdered by another officer. This time, the whole thing was recorded pretty much after he was shot. So like his last dying moments was caught on camera, and it was shared on Facebook, shared on Twitter, shared everywhere that you can imagine. And it even brought, you know, celebrities like LeBron James to even speak out about what's going on. As you can see here, he's got a little tweet about it. Next is going to lead me to Standing Rock, which was a big story that took place last year, where there were oil companies trying to build pipelines all through South Dakota. And the native people in South Dakota were against it because, for one, it was on sacred land. For two, it was their land. It wasn't the United States land for them to be on anyway. And for three, they believed that the oil was bad for the environment, which it is. So first, we're taking steps into the next major event where social media has played an insurmountable part. It was North Dakota, not South Dakota. Sorry about that. And like I said, the issue at hand was the environmental aspect. So that was that. Once this took place, all you seen across Twitter was hashtag North Dakota Pipeline, things like that. You had news crews out there. You had popular people speaking on what's going out there. As you can see on my next slide, you see Bernie Sanders. He even went out there and he tweeted about it. He fought against it. You know, a lot of people were against it, except for the government, of course. But thankfully, the Obama administration decided to make a ruling to halt the construction during the pipeline's last leg in December of 2016. And the decision prompted plenty of cheers, as it had appeared that we had all thought we reached the goal that we wanted. You know, we thought that social media activism actually brought about the change that we were searching for. And then 3-4 months later, when Donald Trump takes office, he reverses that whole thing. And then it's just like, we lost again. And even more recently, after I went through all this, maybe like last week, there was a big pipeline that broke out there. So it just goes to show that the people were right. We should have listened to them, because now, look, we done ruined their land and all of that. And that's never good. And then next is going to bring me to Donald Trump. This man has opened his campaign, and he still now sticks to a highly perceived racist agenda, offending members of the nation possessing every ethnic background other than white. The rap song F Donald Trump by YG and Nipsey Hussle, that definitely took the nation by storm. It was big on social media because it was just speaking out against the things that he stood for in his campaign. As you can see, J.K. Rowling, famous author of Harry Potter and all that, she even tweeted about him, because, I mean, he's doing a pretty bad job, and I mean, he's just offending all people, and people, I mean, all through the election, you know, people were on social media tweeting against him, making memes about him, like, it was really good forms of activism. However, it didn't translate to the polls when he was actually, well, I mean, he didn't have the popular vote. Hillary had the popular vote, but he still ended up winning. So once again, that just went to show that social media activism, it was good, it was strong, but it just wasn't strong enough in leading to the change or the outcome that we wanted. Lastly, I'm going to touch on Colin Kaepernick. So last year, he made headlines all over the world, where, you know, he chose to take a knee when the national anthem was playing. And by doing that, he was just standing out against the wrong and the injustices that take place in the country and the world today. However, of course, the media chose to change it and make it a narrative that he was standing out and speaking against the military and country, which it honestly makes no sense. But, you know, once it goes against what the minority people want, nobody's not trying to hear it. So for that reason, he was blackballed. Nobody really stood up against or stood up with him, you know? I mean, like, we had like a few players that went and followed suit, but majority of them wasn't with it. And then this season, he ends up being blackballed. He's not on the team now, and he's better than half the starting quarterbacks, and he's better than all the second string quarterbacks on every NFL team. So to see him not playing, it just goes to show that him taking his stance, it really took a toll on his career, and he was willing to sacrifice that. Once this took place, social media went in a frenzy, of course, because it was all over the news, and then, you know, the media outlets chose to spin it and make it against the military, which it wasn't. So that definitely sparked outrage on Twitter. And then now to see him not be picked up, it's like every time a quarterback plays trashly, every time a team signs a second-string quarterback that is nowhere near as good as him, because he's been in the Super Bowl, you know what I mean? A bunch of quarterbacks, never been in the Super Bowl, never even been in the playoffs. So when we see signings of players that are not even a quarter as good as he is, we take to Twitter and we speak about it, and we're in outrage about it. Recently this season, a fellow NFL player named LeSean McCoy, he chose to speak out and say that, you know, Colin Kaepernick isn't signed because he's just simply not good enough, which is definitely not true. Because unlike LeSean McCoy, Colin Kaepernick has actually been in the Super Bowl. He's been in the playoffs. And, you know, he has a decorated milestones that McCoy hasn't even achieved yet. So that just goes to show that, you know, people are playing politics, and that's not good. So in conclusion, times are changing, and as technology advances and changes, so does the way that we use said technology and digital platforms to push our fight for activism. The use of social media has been, and it appears that it will be, the platform where activism takes place, because it presents a fighter's chance to be touched by more people, spread to more people, and spread quicker than ever before, which ideally at least should bring justice to those issues that are presented. And although in all four events, social media activism has failed to lead to an outcome of change, it has sparked an open dialogue and conversation between both sides, which is always good when you want to make change, because the other person has to hear you and you have to hear the other person. And sometimes a compromise is necessary. And even though social media activism has not brought us to favor the has not brought us, even though, that's a little interesting. Even though social media activism hasn't brought us the favorable outcomes that we've been reaching for, I do see that changing at some point if we just stick to it and we keep doing it. I mean, eventually something's got to give and something's got to change. So I think once we stick to it, we'll finally reach the changes in at least some situations that we're fighting for. And here's my sources, about a million of them. That's it. Thank you.